I would assume Brennan won the coin flip and chose second, but I guess I don't know for sure. Triple Charmander here for Philip. So, doesn't have Candyzard in hand. Doesn't have turn two Candyzard. But that might not be that big of a deal here, to be honest. Also plays the Lost City, which is big in this matchup. A lot of Charizards have cut Lost City recently. Charizards have cut Lost City recently, but it is actually really, really strong in this matchup. It is really, really, really good in this matchup. And Brennan's hand sucks. It's going to be bench Sableye, attach pass. You bench the Razzard as well? Nope, there's the pass. Over to Philip. Oh, does Philip play the Iono? Yeah, well, you have to play the Iono here now, right? That sucks. Yep. Here comes the Iono. And Brennan's definitely... sigh of relief. What is the thing I'm thinking of? Sigh of relief here from Brennan. I'm trying to think of what I'm thinking of, but... All right, is there the Candyzard here from Philip, though, is the question. Because Candyzard still puts a ton of pressure on Philip with zero cards built up in the Lost Zone. Breathing a sigh of relief. Holy smokes. I got there eventually. I do not see Candyzard in that hand. And with four Sealstone prized... Well, I guess Level Ball can at least get Charmeleon here. So we have a Zard next turn coming out. Level Ball for Charmeleon. I don't think it was prized, so does just need an Ultra Ball or Charizard to get attacking next turn. Is it bad to Iono there? No. The Iono there is probably correct from Philip, because if you just go pass, you're just like waiting for Brennan to potentially top deck something themselves. So like, you may as well take the initiative and be like, well, I know your hand sucks, but I'm gonna go ahead and play the Iono. But if I get Candyzard, even if I give you like a Colress, I'm fine with that trade off. Oh, I think I saw a second Forest Sealstone in the list here for Philip. So it does have access to the Forest Sealstone through the Arvin with the Luminion. Brennan prized the Forest Sealstone, not Philip. Yeah, Brennan prized the Forest Sealstone, not Philip. And actually, Level Ball's for the Pidgey instead, which honestly is probably better to get the... Do we have Candy Pidgey Candyzard in hand here for Philip off the Luminion? I don't think we do. Yeah, Brennan's the one who prized the Forest Sealstone. So yeah, Philip only plays one Forest Sealstone. Two Forest Sealstones pretty bad, to be honest. So I'm glad to see just the one, but... Pidgey comes down. Could have got Charmeleon. Goes for the Pidgey, though. Does have Candy Pidgey in hand next turn, but doesn't quite have Candyzard. Oh, TMD. Oh, Brennan does play. Brennan, I don't think, has played TM Devo in the past. I could be wrong on that. I can actually check Brennan's list from... I kind of wasn't expecting the TM Devo here from Brennan. Did Brennan get top 8 at... Ooh. No, maybe not. And it's just Moon Attach Pass? Jeez. All right, over to Philip. Top deck is Charizard, so that is Candy Pidgey Candyzard in hand here for Philip. But Brennan does have the response of TM Devo. Brennan does have the TM Devo response. So that's pretty good. That's something for Brennan. That's something. It's obviously not great. Brennan probably wants a little bit more than that, but... I don't know if I've seen Brennan play the TM Devo in the past. I don't think Brennan has played the TM Devo in the past. I'm trying to find the last like year. Was it Stuttgart that Brennan got top 8? I don't remember. No, it was Stuttgart, right? Am I tripping? Oh, Liverpool. Yeah, Brennan got top 8 at Liverpool. Yeah, no TM Devo at Liverpool, but has the TM Devo now, which is definitely for the Charizard matchup. Good in other matchups too, but... Yeah, so the Candy Pidgey Candyzard is going to come out here from Philip. And then, yeah, we'll see how... we'll see how surprised Philip is about the TM Devo. Candy Pidgeot, quick search for Candy, Candy Zard, and then Tack. And then, yeah, the TM Devo will be on the way. I don't think Philip plays Melon. Philip better play Melon. That has to be trolling. No, I think I'm pretty sure Philip does play Melon. There's definitely a Melon in Philip's deck. There we go. There better be one. Here we go. Charizard's loaded up. Could get a third energy. Yeah, there's a Charmeleon. I saw it in the deck right there. And does go for another energy thinning here. That's fine. You do want to keep some amount of energy in the deck, especially once you see the Roaring Moon. I actually don't know if I like this, because you want to be able to attack with, like, potentially attack with Radiant Charizard as soon as possible. So now it's going to be harder to attack with Radiant Charizard possibly. I don't think we need to search out this extra energy. He just played Level Ball. Makes no sense without Melon. That is also true. There's no reason to play Level Ball unless you play Charmeleon. But not playing Charmeleon would be trolling. And I would not see a way for Philip to be 5-1-1 without playing Charmeleon, to be honest. So there's the punch. Does have access to rare candy again on the next turn through the Arvin. So can go, if there's no rare candy prize, which I'm actually not sure if there is or isn't, then we could see Philip go Candy Pidgeot, Candy Zard next turn. But then at that point, you definitely need to get Charmeleon out, because otherwise Roaring Moon KO your Charizard means you don't have a follow-up Charizard. So we could even see Philip hold on to... actually, with that in mind, once Philip learns one candy was prized, okay, so there's no possibility for... Oh, that's actually going to make things interesting then. That's up to Comfy. The thing is, like, Brennan doesn't have a loss home built up enough to the point where you could Frenzy Gouging a lone Charizard in play anyways, though. But does actually have... Countercatcher here is probably not great. Fire and a Dark off the Comfy there. I mean, it's just got to be a TM Devo, right? And then I hear you're kind of praying that there's... Because your loss home isn't built up at all here, Brennan... you're praying that you ideally want two rare candy to be prized. There's only one prized. But with the how, like, if the loss zone was just built up a little bit more here from Brennan, then we could see like TM Devo these and then we see a Candy Zard happen here from Philip. Hopefully Philip checked the prize cards here, and when the Arvin gets played here to go find a rare candy, hopefully Philip does not candy out the Pidgeot. Like, just check and then be like, all right, I have to candy the Zard here, that's fine. With only one in the loss zone, there's really no... It is possible for Brennan to get to six more in the loss zone next turn and go Frenzy Gouging KO your into KO your lone Charizard, but probably not going to happen. If it happens, that sucks, we probably go to game two. But also you have a Charmeleon that could respond to the Frenzy Gouging anyways, so it'd probably be fine. Yeah, you could like get one more energy out of the deck here and put it on one of the bench Charmeleons. And then if you do get Frenzy Gouging, if Brennan somehow goes from 1 to 7 next turn, you could go whatever the 30 damage attack on the Charmander is, knock out the Roaring Moon. So, and it looks like, yeah, not going for that. One more Tyrium Devo without Charmeleon put down is a game. No, it's not game. You just then evolve to Charmeleon next turn. You just build up to the point where you have Charmeleon in play. All right, searching out quite a few energy here, actually. Michael with more than one. Could go one on each Charmeleon. You do have to be careful here as Philip, because you don't want Brennan to just like counter catcher. Oh, ooh, might be retreat proofing the board. The one on the... But now your energy is spread so thin and you don't actually have a response to Roaring Moon. I don't like this play at all from Philip. Why would you spread your energy like this? I guess he's the only thing you're afraid of counter catcher here, but now what if you get Frenzy Gouging? You don't have a response of a Charmander. I honestly hope Brennan gets... I think you should just put, like, you should have either left all the energy in the deck, so you just have options of drawing into the energy. Oh, and there's a rare candy top deck, or rare candy off the prize card. So, yeah, I don't like the super spreading out of the energy here. Because if the Frenzy Gouging did come in from Brennan this turn, which is super unlikely, don't get me wrong, it is very, very unlikely. But if it did come in here, then you don't really have a... You don't have a response to it, because you don't have a Charmander with two energy. You could have just left all the energy in the deck and then play Research next turn and just draw into... Theoretically, just draw into the energy that way. Yeah, so I'm not a huge fan of the energy being spread out super, super thin here. I'm also curious if Brennan does play that second TM Devo or not. Like, Sablezard generally plays the two TM... Oh, I think I see it. Was that it? That was a purple-ish card. That could be the TM Devo. I saw it again. I don't know if it's a TM Devo, though. Here we go. Second Comfy. Only one is bad. I don't know. I kind of like... Even one is definitely very helpful in this matchup for Brennan, because it kind of like slows down the like onslaught of Charizards. Like, it's harder to chain Charizards. Like, if you go TM Devo initially and then go like Frenzy Gouging plus Roxanne or something, like if the quick search doesn't get reestablished, which would like be the big thing. It's like the big thing with the first TM Devo after they go Candy Pidgey, Candy Zard, is once you use that TM Devo, it can be really hard to ever get back into Pidgeot again, right? So then once you go like Roxanne, Frenzy Gouging, all of a sudden you can start to take over the game there. I'm curious what Brennan took over the Roxanne there, actually, to be honest. Because Roxanne does come online next turn. I guess it's still not that good of a play next turn, though, because you still only have a loss zone of three. I could see one in Moonbuild. Only one is terrible and the other Sables are. Yeah, I definitely could see that for sure. It was Zard. Oh, it was Zard or Roxanne. All right, I guess I could see it. I don't know, actually, though. You're in a spot where, I don't know, Radzard's just not that good at this point. I feel like you're all in on, like, using multiple moons, maybe. I don't know. All right, the setup's pretty good here from Philip now. Everything is can be moved. Fourth candy used. Yeah, fourth candy's gone. Yo, if Brennan does play There's a research from Philip. Definitely wants to find Charmeleon here, just in case of the second TM Devo, which I don't think we know for sure if Brennan plays or not. I thought I saw it, but I'm not 100% sure. We find the Charmeleon. Good chance of finding it. There's the Ultra Ball. So Charmeleon's on the way. Get rid of, like, well, I don't know, Manaphy and Battle VIP Pass, probably. Thinking about giving up the Pidgey. I think the Pidgey's... I guess it doesn't really matter. They both suck, to be honest. The Manaphy... I guess Manaphy has more HP than Pidgey, actually. So maybe, at this point, you can't actually set up a Pidgey out anyways. So maybe the Manaphy is better. This turn, if we had kept the Roxanne from Brennan, and Brennan does play second TM Devo, which I have no clue, Roxanne plus TM Devo here would have been okay. Because the Charmeleon on the bench, there's actually no energy left in the deck. So the Charmeleon would have to become the Charizard, but there would be no energy for the Charmeleon to actually attack. Wait. Does Philip play a Switch? If Philip doesn't play a Switch, no, Philip probably plays Switch. Is Switch prized? Because what if Brennan counter catches Charmeleon here? Wait, can Brennan win just by going... No, could Brennan have won by going counter catch a Charmeleon? And then if Philip doesn't realize what's going on and Philip goes switch into a Charizard, attack with Charizard without retreating the energy off the Charizard, then Brennan could have gone counter catch a Charmeleon again and then it just gets stuck for the rest of the game, right? That would have actually been sick. That would have been such a sick win condition there. But it would require Philip to misplay. I assume Philip does play the Switch because Philip does play the Radiant Charizard. So you definitely have to play the Switch. It could have been prized though. It could have been prized. So if the Switch is prized there, just bringing up Charmander or Charmeleon wins the game, right? The Charmeleon can't retreat, can't move, can't get energy onto attack. Wasn't one energy in discard? I don't think so. I think it was all in play. There was seven fire energy in play, so I don't think there's any more than that. But we saw a Switch in deck. Okay, so there was at least a Switch, but it could have still worked. Because if Philip just switched into Charizard, but didn't retreat the energy off the Charizard, then you could counter catcher again. You could go like back-to-back counter catchers or counter catcher boss. And that would actually still trap the Charmeleon. That would have been like a sick win condition. Collapse and Super Rod. Oh, true. There probably was Collapse still in the deck as well. All right. The play was probably not possible. The idea is sick, but probably wouldn't work. Yeah, I forgot about Collapse as well. Collapse is also... Maybe Philip doesn't play Collapse, but it's kind of troll to not play Collapse. So we'll probably just assume that Philip has a Collapsed. All right, here we go. Prize cards. All right. Fine prize cards on both sides. Nothing ridiculously bad prize for either player, I don't think here. Just fine. For the level ball, I guess, is like... maybe. I mean, level ball is probably the worst prize card between both players. And we do see... Jesus, man. So Philip's hand isn't dead, but there's not much going on at all. There's an Arvin in there for next turn. And we are going to see the Rhodey for three here as well from Philip. Rhodey for three. Okay. Sure. Weak start. But is gonna have that follow-up of the Arvin or even a research. There's a research in the hand as well. Let's see on Brennan's side. Getting some comb fees. And there's one TM Devo. Was there a TM Devo prize for Brennan? I want to know if there's two or not. Someone in chat said that there was two, I think, though. Two TM Devos. It's a vacuum. Oh, I think the purple card I saw was a vacuum. I think it is only one TM Devo here from Brennan, to be honest. I think the purple card was a vacuum. Question, how does Mirana beat Lost Box Giratina? Just take two prize KOs every turn. Set up your Mew. Put your HP share on your Mew EX. And then they lose. If you go like turn one, if you draw the first two prize cards with Iron Hands and have an EXP share on your Mew EX, the game just ends, basically, for the most part. Also, don't let your Flaffy get trapped in the active. But if your Flaffy's not gonna get trapped, you have an EXP share on your Mew EX and you attack with Iron Hands, the game basically just ends. All right, Tatra Tree from Brennan. Would love to probably get off a Cram attack here, start putting on the pressure, but at least I think it's a Battle VIP pass, so we will start to see some stuff get built up here. No Colossus in hand yet here for Brennan. Only one Switch card in hand as well, so you probably don't get third Comfy here. So it's probably just going to be like Cram. Maybe you just get Cram and nothing. You could get, I mean, Cram third Comfy, I guess, is fine. Double Cram. I don't hate double Cram either, I guess, because the second Cram can hold... The second Cram can hold TM Devo later, or just attacking with Cram aggressively is also good in the matchup. Yeah, goes for the double Crammy. Which, yeah, I mean, Cram's good in this matchup. Punch some Zarge, punch some Pidge, draw an early prize card or two, and use TM Devo for free. Broken. Second Comfy, do we get a... Wait, is there a Colossus in hand there actually for Brennan? It was maybe there at the back of the hand, actually. Wait, Brennan does play four Sealstone, right? Was the Pidgeot prize for Brennan? Because actually, instead of Cram, probably should have got the Pidgeot, right? And it's going to be the pass from Brennan. So a little bit of a slow start here from Brennan, but it is matched by a slow start here from Phillip. So, there's an Arvin in the hand, but Arvin would only get one basic here. Now you could get Nestball plus four Sealstone for your Rotom, and that would get a second basic Pokemon. I guess that would be fine. Pidgeot was in the deck. Oh, I think we should have seen Brennan get the Pidgeot then. I think it was a mistake from Brennan then. Definitely should have got Pidgeot. Definitely should have got Pidgeot there to increase the odds of getting a Colchis through the four Sealstone. Because I don't think Brennan prized the four Sealstone in this game. I could be wrong. Could be also been prized, but pretty sure it wasn't. Pretty sure. Not 100%. Definitely going to see the Nestball here from Phillip. I guess you could also go for a... Oh, actually, wasn't the Nestball's prized for Phillip, I think. The Nestball and the Level Ball are actually prized for Phillip, aren't they? So it has to be an Ultra Ball. An expensive Charmander coming in. Charmander is a... high maintenance Charmander. Got an Ultra Ball for this thing. And then four Sealstone. Probably go get... Ooh, I don't like giving up the Collapse Stadium yet, though, to be honest. I like trying to keep this Collapse Stadium. I think we're probably playing Research next turn. So I would hold the Collapse for a turn. Because if we draw into enough basics, we could get rid of one of these like liabilities off the bench. Or get rid of the Rotom off the bench as a liability. Yeah, I don't like getting rid of the Collapse here. You could have got rid of the Pidgeot, honestly. Because knowing that Brennan plays the TM Devo, I don't think you want to go aggressively for the Candy Charizard. I think you have Candy Charizard in hand here as Phillip. So you just do that next turn. And then you like hold off on the Pidgeot play. So I think Ultra Ball away Pidgeot here from Phillip is what I'd like to have seen. You don't have to be that aggressive with your Pidgeot. Just get a Pidgey down eventually and then kind of go from there. So we're going to force Sealstone and we're going to go get the Pidgey. We don't have that many Pokemon, I guess. Maybe it would have been hard to utilize the Collapse anyways. Yeah, maybe holding on to the Collapse, it doesn't really make that big of a difference, to be honest. I kind of just don't want to see Candy Pidgeot, Candy Charizard now that you know Brennan has the TM Devo. But I guess Phillip does know that all four candies are in the deck in this game, so you can just respond with Candy Candy Meleon as a response to the TM Devo. So maybe it's not that bad, to be honest. You kind of have to double Charmander over Charmander Pidgey, right? No, you don't have to. I don't even know if Brennan plays boss, but if Brennan does play boss, it's only one boss, so you don't have to put down double Charmander here. If there was a higher threat on your Charmander being KO'd, you'd want to, but Brennan's deck doesn't represent that big of a threat. On this turn, oh, I guess because you have Jirachi, there's never any threat, to be honest. Yeah, there's not really that big of a threat to your... Oh yeah, and we're getting the... No, actually, I do. The more I think about it, actually, I do like the keeping up the Collapse, because we're also drawing three cards off of Rotom here. I forgot about the Rotom draw. Shouldn't he use Sealstone for Artisan instead of just Pidgey? No. Because you don't want to give your opponent Artisan. You don't want to give your opponent Artisan. You'd rather just get the Pidgey. And there's a possibility your stadium gets bumped or lost vacuumed or something like that. And there's just the Cram Punch from Brennan. No Colchis still. Just comfy Cram Punch. Brennan does have a boss in hand. Oh, could boss alone Charmander. It is going to happen here, actually. The boss alone Charmander is going to happen. Now, it doesn't mean it was correct for Phillip to have gotten double Charmander last turn. Like, I still don't hate the one Char... Actually, the more I think about it, though, I don't want to see Candy Pidgeot, Candy Charizard from Phillip anyway, so we should have just got double Charmander there, I think, for sure, from Brennan. You do play around the boss play. Now, if you're in a situation up against this deck where you do want Candy Pidgeot, Candy Zard for whatever reason, then I don't hate the idea of not getting the Pidgey. But because of this situation, we don't want to, like, overly utilize our candies anyways. I think this was a mistake from Phillip. And now pushes up the Pidgey over pushing up Manaphy. It's because we're going to candy Pidgeot here. I was so confused for a second. I was like, what? What are we doing here? But this makes sense because we're going to candy out the Pidgeot and then we have free retreat. And we might even leave the Pidgeot in the active here to take a hit. Although running to Rotom would have also been pretty good. It is still pretty awkward for Phillip to get to two Charmanders. One of them can come from quick search and then we have to Arvin for an Ultra Ball. We have plenty of cards to discard with the Ultra Ball. We can even get like a tool card here, like the Choice Belt to discard with the Ultra Ball as well. And there's a Battle VIP Pass in the hand. So maybe it's not that awkward. I guess you're kind of just burning all your Ultra Balls, but I don't even know if that's that big of a deal in the situation, to be honest. If we got a double Charmander, let's just play around the boss. Like I said, I'm not that big of a fan of Candy Pidgeot, Candy Zard in this matchup to begin with. Gives up the justified gloves, which at this point is probably fine. There's a Charmander. Here comes quick search for the second Charmander. But I do think... I don't hate the idea of the Pidgey, one Pidgey Charmander. Except in this scenario, it's not as good because... Because, like, the boss play from Brennan almost never happens. So I don't think you have to overly... You do not have to overly play around the boss happening from Brennan. But in this situation where we don't want to go Pidgey Candy Charmander anyways, we may as well just go double Charmander. And the question is, what do we leave in the active here? And he's going to go to the Rotom. So the Rotom will take a hit from a Cram. And then for Brennan to get... But see, this is where the Rotom taking a hit here... I guess you always make the Rotom take the hit over the Pidgeot because then it gets TMD Vokeo'd. But this is where we could utilize the Collapse Stadium all of a sudden, right? So now we could retreat the Rotom next turn and then collapse it away to remove it as like a something that gets KO'd later. Sableye can't ever KO it because there's Jirachi in play, but like Brennan could Palpad back the boss, or Philip gets ahead in the prize exchange, and then Brennan could counter catcher the Rotom for the last two prize cards possibly. So once again, really do not like the Collapse Stadium getting discarded earlier, and we could see it come back to punish Philip here with this Rotom potentially becoming the last two prize cards at the end of the game. So we'll see. Here comes the Charizard ability. Finally going to see an attack here. Everything's set up pretty good here for TM Devo from Brennan now. TM Devo. But we are going to see Philip rush down this Charmeleon as well. So here comes the Charizard. And then we'll see the quick search here. Probably just grab Charmeleon and then put the Charmander to a Charmeleon. And then honestly, here from Philip, has boss in hand. I kind of just maybe just boss Comfy. Yeah, I think if I'm Philip here, I'm just bossing Comfy and KOing Comfy here. And then you let your Charizard get punched. And then... If Brennan wants a TM Devo to KO this Charizard next turn, that's fine. Let that Charizard get knocked out. They get one prize. But if not, they're just punching Charizard again with Cram and you just boss the other Comfy. And they just kind of run them out of draw power on the board. Yeah, so there's Charmeleon. We'll see if the boss happens here from Philip. But yeah, I think I'm trying to limit Brennan's access to... I'm trying to limit Brennan's access to Colrush next turn, more so than anything. KOing a Cram is not super relevant. Especially with another Cram just on the back line. Yep, there's a boss on the Comfy. This does let Brennan get in. Brennan will be able to send up the other Comfy to hopefully find a Colrush on this next turn, but only has the one Comfy to work with now. All right, this one doesn't have an energy on it. A counter catcher. Ooh, we could see. What about counter catcher KO Charmeleon before it gets to evolve? That was the Clara. We get our Comfy back and we get some energy. Yeah, what about counter catcher KO Charmeleon here? I don't hate that. Seems okay. You can also punch the active Charizard. Oh, they are tied on prize cards. Never mind. Don't mind me. I just assumed Brennan was behind. All right. No counter catcher. Punch the active. Then Philip will evolve the bench Charizard. Oh, wait a second. Brennan can just board lock Philip with a TM Devo play. So yeah, you do the punch here. Well, hold up. We have to find the TM Devo, but hold on. Punch this. Philip on this turn. Oh, so actually, Philip shouldn't evolve the Charmeleon here. Philip shouldn't evolve Charmeleon here. Because otherwise, that allows Brennan to go countercatcher, punch that Charizard, and then TM Devo board wipe the Charizards. So from Philip here, what you should do is just attack. Maybe, yeah, honestly, just attack. Because if you evolve to Charizard here, that opens up Brennan to do that play. But if you just leave it as a Charmeleon, then Brennan has to go countercatcher your Charmeleon. And then you just super rod the Charmander and Charmeleon back into the deck, bench Charmander for the turn. And then you have the option of Candy Charizard next turn to be able to continuously attack. So yeah, this is a misplay from Philip. And actually gives a big opening here for Brennan. Now Brennan has a countercatcher in hand, can countercatcher punch the Charizard, and then has the Roxanne on the follow-up to dig for that TM Devo. Hopefully Brennan finds a Colrush this turn to go with that, but we'll see. There's a choice spell. And also, throughout all of this, the Ionos aren't hitting very hard because Brennan's not drawing prize cards. And then Brennan can even like wait towards the end of the game. There's a boss again on a Comfy. This boss I like a little bit less, but it's still probably correct here from Philip. Yeah, it's still probably correct. Just reduce the draw potential here from Brennan. Now, Brennan also has to see this line as well. Nest Ball and Forest, I believe it's Nest Ball and Forest Seal Stone. Oh no, it's a gate, excuse me. But yeah, hopefully Brennan sees the line here and goes for it. Countercatcher in hand. Roxanne in hand as well, I believe. Espoir for another Comvia, I assume is what's going to happen here. And I think the TM Devo is in the deck. I think, yeah, I see it right there. TM Devo is in the deck. Oh, when did the Pidgeot hit the Lost Zone? I didn't even realize that happened, to be honest. It was last turn. I was like thinking we keep the... I was thinking we had a 4 Seal Stone there to grab, but we didn't. But if we did have a 4 Seal Stone to grab, then we could have Nest Ball for Pidgeot plus 4 Seal Stone. All right, here comes the Countercatcher. You got to go after the Charizard with the Charmeleon, right? You never go after the Pidgey here. I think that's what Brennan's thinking about, right? Is thinking about going after... Wants to get rid of the Pidgey instead? And just leave a Charizard set up? How does this break down? Because then you can follow up on the next Charizard. You can follow up on the next Charizard by KOing it with Roaring Moon. This does take away the possibility of Philip following up with Candy Pidgeot, Candy Charizard as a response to TM Devo next. No, but you couldn't do Candy Charizard because there's no... You wouldn't be able to do Candy Charizard because there's no Charmander to work with. This would allow Philip to go like attach fire for turn here into Candy Pidgeot, attach fire, knock out whatever has the TM Devo on it, I guess. He could also countercatcher Charizard next turn and board wipe. That is also true. There could be another countercatcher here, but I think you should start by going countercatcher Charizard. Because if you don't find the countercatcher play, but you find the TM Devo, I think you just go for the TM Devo. So yeah, I actually don't like this play from Brennan. I think you should always start with countercatcher punch Charizard, because at the very least, if you can't find the other countercatcher to combo with everything, then you can at least board wipe the Charizards. But now you're in a situation for Brennan here where, like, if you only find TM Devo, but you can't find this other countercatcher to go with everything, then there's always going to be a Charizard punching you. Another boss thinking... I wouldn't play this last boss here as Philip. I actually don't like this. This is the last boss from Philip. Yeah, you see Brennan immediately goes to check. This actually lets Brennan now aggressively bench stuff like Radiant Charizard and Roaring Moon, as long as Brennan doesn't go ahead on the prize exchange. So that's actually a really bad play from Philip to bench that, to use that boss. Let's let... he has second countercatcher in hand. Oh, does he really? Okay, if that's the case, then this play is fine here from Brennan. Yeah, that last boss there from Philip is really bad. That last boss from Philip here is really, really bad. Oh, there is second countercatcher in hand. You're right. Okay, I didn't think it was in there, so I didn't love the idea of it, but... With second countercatcher in hand. And you see, now we can even aggressively bench the Radiant Charizard here from Brennan. You know it can't be boss KO next turn, so you get to set up these plays way more aggressively. Yeah, I really don't like that. That last boss there from Philip was really bad. That was a really bad play from Philip. Bro hasn't played a single course. That's crazy. Yeah, but it's all coming together here. As a countercatcher, TM Devo is in deck. Now, we do need to find the TM Devo. We don't just have it. But it is there for Brennan. Just needs to go get access to it. Looks like he's maybe going to go back into the deck. Does have another Mirage Gate in hand. Will Jirachi stop TM Devo? No, that's not what Jirachi does. Jirachi specifically stops damage placement from basic Pokemon. It has nothing to do with effects of attacks. All right, getting a Comfy here. I don't even know if Brennan needs another Comfy, to be honest. Maybe he does. Actually, Brennan didn't put any energy on the Radiant Charizard there, which is weird. I assumed that Psychic or the Dark Energy would have made its way to the Radiant Charizard there for sure. And now it's just Super Rotting back just Comfy energy? Not even two energy, just one? This is a weird sequence here from Brennan. I mean, getting the other Comfy back seems fine, especially because you want to dig through your deck. I guess that's the point of getting the Comfy back here from Brennan, is to potentially draw into it so you can put it on your bench. Chorus, Fire, Dark, Mirage Gate. I think there was a Mirage Gate in Brennan's hand, though, that Brennan could have played before using this Chorus. Wasn't there? Yeah, you could have Mirage Gated to the Charizard, but maybe you want to save the Mirage Gate for the Roaring Moon, I guess. Once again, the Roaring Moon could be benched here, but you maybe don't want to bench it too soon ahead of time here as Brennan. You don't want to bench the Roaring Moon too soon ahead here as Brennan. Because if you do end up ahead on prize cards as Brennan, then Philip could like KO for the last two prize cards or something. So holding off on the Roaring Moon. All seems fine. There's the punch. Still needs to find the TM Devo. But Philip doesn't win for two turns. Brennan does need to draw five prize cards still. So three of the prize cards will come from the TM Devo, but then still needs to draw two more prize cards. And we don't know where those are going to come from quite yet. And see, this is why Philip shouldn't have evolved the Charizard. If Philip doesn't evolve Charizard, then Philip either always has a Charmeleon in play or has a Charmander in play when the TM Devo hits, which increases the odds of Philip being able to continuously chain attack. So that was like a huge, huge mistake from Philip to evolve the Charmeleon to a Charizard, and also a big mistake to have played the boss when Philip did. Because this will let Brennan play a lot more freely with the bench at this point, depending on where the price trade is at. I think Philip could even like bench the Roaring Moon next turn if he really wanted to. I don't know if that's correct. I believe Brennan does play Palpad here, so Brennan's win condition here can be TM Devo into Boss KO Rotom as well. Once again, this is also another situation where Collapse would have been a big deal as well, because it would allow you to open up a bench space. Yeah, because in chat, what was it? Yeah, so Philip needs Collapse, Vacuum, Charmander this next turn. That would be great, but Philip, for some reason, discarded the Collapse earlier, and now we don't have our Collapse Stadium. Which would not only remove the Rotom from play to limit that as a possibility for Brennan to win the game, but we could also have done that, right? We could have gone Collapse to open up a bench space plus Vacuum to bench a Charmander this turn from Philip as well. But yeah, it even got worse than I thought in the moment. In the moment, it was bad. Now it even got worse. Could play the Vacuum here as well to get rid of that Battle VIP pass and get rid of the Four Seal Stone to reduce the impact of potential Roxanne. Doesn't do that. So now Roxanne could hit Philip harder here. But Brennan probably isn't going to play Roxanne this turn. I don't think Brennan should play the I think Brennan just should play Colress and just dig for TM Devo. Because just got Iono. So everything that was in the hand was not TM Devo. Is there a TM Devo found here? The Comfy for Seal Stone. And a Switch. Has a ton of Switch cards in hand. So you probably get rid of the Switch, keep the Comfy in the Nest Ball. Because if you find a Super Rod, then you can Super Rod a Comfy back to the deck. You can Super Rod a Comfy back to the deck. And then use a third Comfy here. Decent amount of cards on the bottom of the deck are not TM Devo. So then you just start going into Comfies here as Brennan. TM Devo? Another Comfy, I think. I thought there was two Comfy in the discard pile. I guess I'm tripping. Two. Dude, the cat just came into the room and he just starts chirping. Literally, Nugget is literally just chat. There is the TM Devo! Dude, shut up. And now he left. Release Charmeleon on the bench. What stops the Countercatcher punch onto the Charmeleon? Nothing, but then it allows you to bench a Charmander. And then you have the possibility of Candy Charizard next turn. But now, you're just going to get TM Devoed and have no possibility of Candy Charizard from Philip on this next turn. And then you lose in like two attacks here. So escape ropes are pretty good here from Brennan. I actually would like to see Brennan maybe keep the escape rope, to be honest. I don't know if there's another switch card in hand. Because even if Philip is able to create a Charizard, then you can just escape rope around the Charizard multiple times or something like that. Like this next turn, Brennan's going to be able to go Cram Punch for KO, and then escape rope wins the game on the following turn from Brennan. So I think I would like to have seen Brennan keep... I would also probably want to see Brennan keep the Radiant Charizard. Just send up Cram here, probably. Send up Cram with TM Devo, TM Devo the board. Next turn, Cram Punch, and Cram Punch actually... gets a prize card, and then Radiant Charizard plus Escape Rope gets the last prize card. Because there's not going to be two things on the board that have more HP than Radiant Charizard. So I don't love Radiant Charizard being pushed here over the Cram. And also, I like the idea of keeping both Escape Ropes here. Because you're going to get Iono here, possibly, as Brennan, and then you're going to be in a tough spot to maybe recover. The Rotom actually here will be good for Philip, though, as recovery, though, to be honest. So the Rotom here for Philip will be good recovery. There's the TM Devo. See, now something could be put on the bench like Luminion that plays around like Cram plus Escape Rope. Now you could go like Escape Rope retreat the Radiant Charizard. But now if you attack with Radiant Charizard here and then Philip... If Philip can go bench Charmander and then Brennan goes attack with Radiant Charizard, then Philip goes Candyzard, KO, Radiant Charizard plus bench Luminion, then Cram plus Escape Rope doesn't win the game here. So Brennan really should have left Cram in the active here, not the Radiant Charizard. We could see Brennan get punished for that. Now, Philip also has the Iono in the hand, which is really good here, of course, but needs to find a Charmander. That's not a Charmander. So we have to see... Please play this Vacuum. Get rid of this just thin out those two cards out of the deck. Please play the Vacuum. Play the Vacuum, please. Gosh damn it. All right. Well, Philip needs to find a Charmander off these two cards. What Pokemon in his deck needs to be attacked with Radzard? Charizard EX, Radzard, Luminion. All those... Charizard EX, Radzard, Luminion. Is there a Charmander? Lost City, Rare Candy, no Charmander. Gonna draw three with Rotom here. Also, the Charizard could just get stuck in the active as well. Here comes the draw three from Rotom. So Brennan does have the attack with Charizard, but then if Brennan can't move the Charizard next turn, that gives Philip another turn. And the more I think about it, the worse setting up Radiant Charizard is here for Philip. Yeah, the more I think about it, the worse it is. There's the attach to the Radzard. Brennan's realizing the potential of having to retreat the Radzard here now. All right, Jirachi sent up from Philip. Hand is not good for Philip here, obviously. The draw is a switch. Switch is good, though. Wait, no. Is switch that good? No, switch is not that good. Never mind. So we have to see Arvin for a Charmander here from Philip. There's also 14 minutes left, so there's plenty of time. There is plenty of time for someone to win game three. There's an okay amount of time for someone to win game three. I'm not going to say plenty of time. There's not plenty of time. There's an okay amount of time. So this has to be an out for a Charmander. This is still not looking great here for Philip. And I have those other two dead cards in the deck in the vacuum in the Battle VIP pass. Honestly, I hope Brennan whiffs next turn the attack and gets punished for putting Radzar in the active. And then after that, I hope Philip plays Iono and draws into vacuum Battle VIP pass. So they were both players get punished, and then Brennan ends up with the win in here in game two. That's my hope off of these mistakes here. Does have a candy in hand, so a top deck Charizard is also really good here. You gotta get rid of Lost City. You get rid of Lost City Countercatcher here. Depending on how many energy are left, because you can just accelerate enough energy into play to attack with it. You don't have to do it like that. Oh, there's only one energy in the deck. So we also need to find an energy here for Philip as well. That's another thing with Philip here as well. When Philip set up that second Charizard off the Charmeleon, accelerated an extra energy into play that did not need to be accelerated into play. And there's a Rotom for three. There's the attach retreat, cram punch. So yeah, Brennan already ready to go. There's the attack. And honestly, Brennan could have showed that to Philip probably after the Arvin was played, but just, I guess just to play around like any random shenanigans. Can't Brennan attach retreat for game? Yeah, I just didn't know if Brennan had an energy in hand or not. I didn't see the energy in hand there from Brennan, but Brennan did have the energy. But if Brennan doesn't have energy there, then it is possible for Brennan to lose. All because Brennan sent up Cram there. Alright, game three, not a ton of time left. Philip will be going second, I assume, here. But yeah, even if Philip had not evolve the Charizard to a Charmeleon, the matchup still would have been close from there, I think, because we would have seen the Countercatcher on the Charmeleon, and then would have come down to Roxanne. Oh, well, I guess there was no Roxanne, to be honest, for Brennan on the TM Devo turn. So Brennan might have had to wait like one more turn there. So it would have got interesting. If Philip had played a little bit better, it would have got really interesting from there, to be honest. Alright, here we go. Got a basic. Nope, second mulligan. I mean, that's good for Brennan, but it's just taking up more time. Bro, Peter, you already know I'm going to skip that song. Alright, here we go. Seven. Did find a basic. I can't tell how good the hand is. All right, take a look at these prize cards. The boss's prize for Brennan. Brennan definitely has the worst of the two prize cards, I think, for sure. Also, open Manaphy, which is not great. That does just kind of eat up a bench space. It's not very good in this matchup. Does this eat up a bench space? The comfy. For a second there, I was so confused by what the heck you were saying, video game, but I get it now. At least we see a more aggressive comfy start here from Brennan. Doing some thinking. Dude, the hand still sucks. Why do Brennan's hands always suck? Honestly, conclusion could be the deck sucks. There's a switch card to the comfy. Thinking about retreating to the Roaring Moon instead here. Every hand that Brennan has had so far in this game has sucked. It's just been a bad hand. Like, it's, the hand just has sucked. So getting more aggressive with the Roaring Moon there puts that down. There is an Iono here to hopefully give Brennan a better hand. The Call for Family is also online here for Philip, though. Yep, there we go. Iono. Also, Justified Gloves could be big here. Could allow Philip to, like, Gust KO the Roaring Moon off Brennan's bench after Brennan only takes one knockout. There's a Colress gifted from Philip's Iono. There's a lot of Pokemon there for Philip, or a lot of Pokemon search. Oh, I thought there was a Battle VIP pass, but not. There's a Nest Ball and a Call for Family, though, so that's still pretty good. Not bad. Here comes the Nest Ball, and then we'll see the Call for Family eyeing up the Pidgeot and probably two Charmanders. Peter, I'm just going to skip all your song requests. Or might be Nest Ball for Rotom, then Call for Family for two Charmanders here, to be honest. So might skip the Pidgey here. We'll see. Going with the level ball. Oh, so I think we will see the Pidgey grabbed here then. Oh, wait, but if we're calling for family... Wait a second. Why would we get Rotom? Oh, we want to get Rotom because we have Arvin. Okay, that makes sense. I was like a little bit confused there. If we're not going to use Rotom, why did we get Rotom? But want us to use the Force Seal Stone with the Arvin next turn. So we got 8 minutes left. Brennan's got to start cooking. Just play actions. Here we go. Horse is in. I think Brennan does have an understanding of needing to play aggressive here. Probably lost on the countercatcher and the dark energy. We are trying to be the aggressor here overall. Definitely want to keep one of the dark energy for sure. Gets rid of the switch though. Opts to keep the countercatcher. Sure. Definitely has the comfy attack set up in the hand already. Actually, is that a Mirage Gate versus comfy? Good question. Only has access to one comfy, but the Mirage Gate's pretty important to just be aggressive. To be able to like get off these early aggressive attacks. And here comes the Nest Ball. I guess it could get another comfy and just like not draw a prize card yet to keep Roaring Moon online, but I think just getting the prize card here and being aggressive makes the most sense. So there's the grab. Cram is on the way. Doesn't Brennan only play four Seal Stone? Does it make sense to run Town Store? Oh no, you have TM Devo as well. There's two. Brennan plays two tools. Okay. So I guess it's like effective, like a second out to each tool. I was so confused for a second. All right. Phillip's got Candy Charizard, Candy Pidgeot, Candy Charizard. We talked about this last game, though. And especially with this hand, to be honest, Candy Pidgeot, Candy Charizard does not seem that good. I mean, if you don't prize any candies actually here, I think you could get the extra candy in the hand here. Actually, it might work out for Phillip here. I think you can end up with an extra candy in hand. Because you have Ultra Ball for Pidgeot. And you have four Seal Stone. You could actually just keep four Seal Stone around here, I think. You can go Candy Pidgeot, Arvin for four Seal Stone plus Candy, and then Quick Search plus Candy, Candy Zard. And then you have the four Seal Stone that can recover a candy here to get the response knockout. Can't Philip get countered and Gloves annihilated the moon here? Oh, that is true. We could see Countercatcher Gloves here. Actually, Philip had it there. If Countercatcher was in the deck. Philip did have it, actually. I didn't really think about that in the moment. Wait, does Philip still have it with doing this? Quick search. Yeah, Philip still has... Oh, no, we can't get the gloves now. Oh, yeah, Philip could have gone KO Moon here. And then would have had... I don't know what the hand would have looked like after that. Y'all are trolling me with these song requests right now. But yeah, Philip could have gone KO the Roaring Moon off the bench here. But wouldn't have been able to candy out the Pidgeot. I'm actually not sure about that, to be honest. Yeah, I kind of like that play actually from Philip to maybe just go for the KO on the Roaring Moon. You wouldn't have had any follow-up, so TM Diva would have been a little obnoxious, but if you get like a good card off the prize cards, you're still in a fine spot, right? Because it could have been Ultra Ball for Zard. You have Candy in hand, Candy Zard, and then the Arvin gets Justified plus Countercatcher. As the Arvin's definitely not Pride. The Arvin's the Justified Gloves isn't prized. The Countercatcher could be prized here, so maybe the play wasn't possible. But then that does leave Philip with like a two card hand from prize cards plus top deck, which I don't know how good that is. But in a situation where you're trying to like, where this like seems like an aggressive like prize race situation, I feel like that was maybe the better play from Philip. To be honest, I don't know. It feels like that was maybe the better play from Philip, where it feels like, because it feels like this situation is like super, you gotta be super aggressive. Burning gets rid of the psychic energy and the switch cart, keeps the force seal stone, the beach court, and the comfy. Could maybe even just like put the force seal stone down on the Pidgeot if you can find the Pidgeot this turn from Brennan. Just to have it set up in play. Because Philip doesn't have a ton of cards in hand, so the vacuum would probably be unlikely. Here comes a gate. Is there enough energy in the deck? I have no clue. There's a fire. There's a dark. All right, we got it. So the Frenzy Gouging is coming here for Brennan. I guess the response from Philip can just be attack with the Baby Charmander, though, for with one fire energy and just go, just poke the poke the Roaring Moon. You don't have to respond with a Charizard. But maybe you, no, I guess you don't want to, you do not want to Candy out of Charizard here, right? Because then TM Diva would hurt a lot. That's a response from Brennan. So you probably don't want to go into TM Diva range here. Or you don't want to put yourself in a board state where TM Diva is like pretty brutal. Because you only have one Candy left. And if you Candy out that Charizard and then Brennan responds with a Roaring Moon, then you just lose the game, I guess. I guess that's not guaranteed from Brennan, but it's possible. Just a retreat and Frenzy Gouging. So from Philip here, there's very little setup on Brennan's board, though. So if Philip can just go knock out the moon, honestly, I don't hate Candy Zard KO plus Iono. And here comes the Pidgey send up here from Philip. So I think Iono top deck would be crazy here from Philip, or Luminian top deck, and then get an Iono. Dude! All right, why? What are we thinking about? Force Seal, slam it! Force Seal Stone, play Iono! Dude, Philip, stop cooking, bro! This is when you just don't cook. You just stop cooking and you just start throwing ingredients, bro. You just hurl the ingredients and whatever comes out, we eat it. It doesn't matter what it is. We just eat it. We don't have a choice. We're starving and we don't have time to cook. We have like 5 minutes to make our food. We have a bunch of ingredients, but you don't care. You just need to get the food made before you starve and die. So you just take the ingredients, you throw the ingredients at the thing, and whatever happens, happens. Philip is doing way too much cooking for how good of a top deck that was the top deck. And Philip is just like, let me cook. Don't cook. Stop cooking. Philip is still cooking, bro. Play the cards. Get him in there. Quick search. Let's go. Put it in the oven. We're cooked. Go. Fire energy? No, Candy Zard? This is what I'm not sure. Oh, wait. Is there zero fire energy in the deck? No, dude. All right, cook a little bit longer. Am I tripping or is there zero fire energy in the deck? I gotta be tripping, right? Yo! No way! Alright, this is what I was talking about. I did want to see Philip play faster, but that's hilarious. So what Philip needed to do there was force seal stone for Super Rod and then quick search for a fire energy and just do the 30 damage. Also, this play gets like hella bodied by TM Devo anyway, so I don't even know how much I like this play from Philip to begin with. I don't even think I really like this play from Philip at all, to be honest. The like Candy Zard versus just, I think KO with Charmander is just a better play from Philip to begin with, to be honest. So I would like to see you go for the for that play from Philip. Retreat to the Jirachi and pass? Dude, that's crazy. No, Rotom draw for three! Forgot about the Rody. No. Switch card immediately from Brennan. Three prize cards left to get here from Brennan. And it's KO'ing the Jirachi here, so Sableye could be actually become a real threat. Brennan's hand sucks. Gets rid of the Force Seal Stone to build up the Lost Zone. Bench Sableye. There's retreat from the Beach Court. Bench Sableye. Attach to the Comfy, just in case the Beach Court gets bumped. Bench Sableye. Dude, Bench Sableye. Gosh darn it. Now if you get Iono'd here, you don't have... It's like that much harder to... Why would you not Bench Sableye here? You always Bench Sableye here. You just want the attacker in play option. You're KO Jirachi this turn as well. All right, Arvin coming in from Philip. We are going to see the Super Rod happen. Recover three energy. All right, thankfully for Brennan, Philip did not have an Iono. So That's not happening. Super Rod coming in. A couple different ways for Brennan to win the game now. Could KO the roadie. Yeah, Brennan can go Sableye to the roadie, boss KO it next turn with Cram. Could also go Roaring Moon, KO Azard. That's going to be hard to pull out of this hand, though, for Brennan. The punish on the Force Heal Stun lost vacuumed. Philip used the Force Heal Stun last turn. It just doesn't show it on the graphic up top. But yeah, Philip did use Force Heal Stun last turn. This is turn one? No, this is turn zero. I believe. Is this turn zero or turn one? I think Brennan passed in time for this to be turn zero. Turn zero, right? Turn zero. Yeah, turn zero. All right, finally got the Super Rod off. Dude, that was a hilarious sequence there from Philip, though. And then here we go. Punch from the Zard. On the moon. Moon is gone now. Three proc cards left for Philip. So Philip can't win this game. Philip has one more turn. Brennan can win this game. Yeah, it is possible for Brennan to win. I wonder what that... Was that a Pokegear or Escape Rope or something? Escape Rope looks like. Brennan just needs to find Sableye. Put damage on Rotom here. Or Roaring Moon KO active. And then look for boss KO on... Jirachi. Clara could allow... Oh, did Philip recover the Jirachi or no? With the Super Rod. Yeah, did Philip recover the Jirachi or no? I didn't even remember. I didn't even know. No? Did not recover the Jirachi? No! Another throw from Philip. So we could just see back-to-back Jirachis here from Brennan then. Or, excuse me, back-to-back Sableyes. Back-to-back Sableyes. Back-to-back Jirachis would be crazy. That would suck. It wouldn't do anything. The Clara discard is interesting then from Brennan there. But it's keeping around the option of the Roaring Moon, I guess. But the Clara was good for the Roaring Moon as well. I feel like Brennan maybe could have got rid of the Nest Ball there. Wait, where's the Roaring Moon? Is it not in the discard pile? Am I tripping? There's the Super Rod. Is Brennan trying to play for the win this turn? Brennan actually might be trying to play for the win this turn. I don't even know if it's possible, though. Has the Nest Ball in hand, so you could go... I don't know if there's another... What other energy's in the deck here from Brennan, to be honest. This could be a mistake on the energy grab here. I assume the Nest Ball is going to get played right now to put the Roaring Moon on the bench here from Brennan. And then you go into the... And if you get the win with Moon, you go for it. If not, you go Sableye the Rotom off the gate. We'll see what Brennan goes for, though, here. Maybe isn't going to play the Nest Ball first. Okay, isn't going to play the Nest Ball first. Just keep the option of it. I assumed we'd see the Nest Ball first. Pidgeot and Force... Here comes the escape rope. I don't know if I like that Super Rod there from. I kind of don't like the way that Brennan played that. To me, I don't know. I guess that's maybe fine for Brennan to play it that way. Yeah, I guess that's maybe fine here. All right, escape rope goes down. So Philip should probably send up. You should end up Charmander here every time, right? You just push Charmander. Yeah, you just push Charmander every time here as Philip. It's not even really a question, to be honest. Charmander is always the push up here. Is Devo still alive? It is, but I don't think Brennan can win with the Devo play. Because if you Devo, then you need like Devo into boss KO Rotom or something. Oh, wait, you could go Sableye the Charizard and the Pidgeot into TM Devo. Oh, wait, you could do that. You could Sableye the Pidgeot and the Charizard into TM Devo. Oh, is that just a play, actually? Or you could KO the Charmander to get a prize card if you really want, but then you get Iono to one less. You could also Nest Ball for the Cram here as well, so that way you just have something in play that can hold the Team Devo if you need to retreat from Comfy to Comfy and burn that fire off the Comfy if your Beach Court gets played. Or you could... Oh, see, that's the question. Do you just put it all on the Rotom? Yeah, what do you do here as Brennan? Do you just put it all on the Rotom? You just realize the Sableye? Yeah, maybe. Could just grab Cram here. Yeah, there's a couple of different ways to play this, to be honest, here as Brennan. You've got some options. I think you play for the TM Depot route, though, right? Every line of play gets punished. Not punished. Every line of play gets taken away by Collapse Stadium. So you just have to hope Philip doesn't get Collapse Stadium. But Collapse KOs, removes every line of play from Brennan, though. Besides Roar and Moon KO active. The only thing that Collapse doesn't get rid of is Roar and Moon KO active. No Psychic. Has the gate in hand. The gate will get the Psychic here for Brennan. Burn the 4 Seal Stone. Yeah, definitely don't put it on the... Oh, it's going for the Cram knockout? I think this play is the worst of the plays. No! This means you have to have Roaring Moon next turn. What? No Psychic in deck? Oh, did Brennan not recover Psychic with the Super Rod? With none in... Oh, that was a misplay from Brennan then to not recover the Psychic energy. Yeah, this the game plan choice here from Brennan is super poor. So Brennan's plan is punch with Cram, no Psychic in deck. Oh, but we could have recovered a Psychic. So that was a mistake from Brennan on the Super Rod. I think Brennan just didn't see the Sableye line. I think Brennan just did not see the Sableye line. So Philip misplayed by not recovering Jirachi to protect from Sableye on Rotom. And then Brennan misplayed here by not going for Sableye TM Devo. The way this should have worked out is Philip should have recovered Jirachi with Super Rod last turn to stop Sableye on Rotom. And because of that, then Brennan's play on this turn is to go Sableye 50-70 on Charizard and Pidgeot by recovering the Psychic energy with the Super Rod. And then Philip has to like respond with the Collapse Stadium, but has so few Pokemon in play and only Quick Search. Like the chance that the Collapse Stadium play happens is just like not going to happen probably. And we see that, yeah, the draw here does not give it to Philip. There's a counter catcher. So we're just going to see Philip go counter catcher the Manaphy and pass with Charizard in the active. Because Philip can't win this game anymore. So it comes down to Brennan. Brennan still could attack with Roaring Moon here. But this card would have to be Roxanne for that to happen, I think. Yeah, this card has to be Roxanne. It's a boss. Yeah, so no win can... Oh! If Brennan had done the Sableye damage to the Rotom, then this would have won with boss KO with Cram. But because of the possibility... Yeah, I mean, that was like... As soon as Philip didn't recover the Jirachi with Super Rod, that was a possibility for Brennan to go for that route. To go for Sableye, or Sableye into boss KO. Is that a Roxanne in hand? Oh, wait. But Brennan can still get the Roxanne off of the Comfy here, though. I guess Colrus is possible as well. I think it would need to be Roxanne, but... Yep, that's a tie. Dude, that's tough. But